Breaking news. Actor and musician Jussie Smollett from the hit show Empire was attacked and beaten early this morning in Chicago, and police say it could be a hate crime.
Yeah, we are in a post-racial society, right?
Jussie Smollett from Empire was the victim of a brutal, heinous hate crime.
Oh, really? It's a hate crime, so there's no speculation there. It's just he was the victim of a brutal, heinous hate crime.
It all started when two individuals yelled out racial and homophobic slurs.
We live in an accepting society that holds no contempt for the LGBTQ community, right?
They haven't caught anybody. There's no video footage of this. It's just a guy saying a story.
His name is Jussie Smollett, and he was beaten, and it seems like it was a racially and sexual orientation motivated beating.
Jussie is a friend. Yeah, I know he's been a good friend of mine. But lately something's changed, it ain't hard to define. Jussie's got himself a girl and I wanna make her mine. And she's watching him with those eyes.
Two men approached him, two men, white men.
White men, oh, they were white men. That's key, very key. That one word, the white part of that sentence, is the only reason you're hearing this.
And then when you hear that it's seemingly both racially and motivated by sexual orientation, it just sucks.
It's almost mythical, these two guys, two white men in ski masks. Now, is it possible? Yeah, everything's possible. Is it likely? No, not at all. And also, even if they did beat this guy up, totally unjustified, they still have a side of the story. There's still another perspective here. We cannot be this gullible as a society. And if Jussie is gonna report like whatever happened to him, he goes in and goes, oh, this is my story. That's one thing. He is not an anchor. He is not an institution called journalism. We have to have filters between some rando fucking gay actor who got into a skirmish and wants to paint it a certain way, and the millions of people who are now gonna waste our mental energy to look at the story and hear their biased perspective and just be like, oh, cool. And by the way, this is meant to divide us even further. And I think race vulture is my shit.
The two shadowy figures wanted for questioning in the assault of Empire actor Jussie Smollett have been tracked down by police.
Ravia, the attorney for those two persons of interest, she was with both of those men for much of the day. She says that both of them were picked up at O'Hare last night at Customs. They were actually in Nigeria visiting family, and at some point last night, Chicago police were also at their family's home.
Want to attack this dude? Like, how he's not a person that somebody would say him. We're going after. He's not that. I'm not saying he's not relevant, but we don't talk about him every day. He's not somebody that's big in the news every day. He's not like. So I just don't even understand why that's just. It's such a random thing, and it seems like such an elaborate plan. But when you look at it, it's like this does not make any fucking sense.
And he's holding her in his arms late, late at night.
Cover all of their,
you
their
know,
bases.
I wish that I had Jussie's girl.
But it's like when you look at
I
it,
I wish that I had Jussie's
no
girl.
Sense.
Let's talk further.
Where can I find
I'm not
a woman
go
like
with you
that?
Because hate crimes do exist.
And I'm
absolutely
looking in the
so
mirror
this
all the time,
crime,
wondering what she
that.
Don't see
right.
in
don't
me. I've
what?
Been funny,
us.
I've been cool
us.
With
and,
the lines.
You know, that
ain't that the
era
way love's supposed to be?
I gotta think twice about if I'm allowed to think something.
Right.
I don't believe that nigga was it was a hate crime. I don't believe that.
Right.
Sorry.
Tell me, where can I find a woman
right,
like that? Like Jussie's girl.
That is the case because
I wish that I had Jussie's girl.
100%, 100%.
So now you're taken away.
I want Jussie's girl.
Which I don't even know if it's a word, but it's like
where can I find? find a woman like that, like Jesse's girl.
In the event that it is false,
I wish that I had Jesse's girl.
Like to add the political element to it.
I want
to
Y'all fast forward. Let me just explain a little more. So, what was the last thing said? Cops call 45 minutes later. A funny letter sent to Fox News. Oh, Lee Daniels, post and delete. That's fine. But then the very next post I saw was from Taraji.
Right.
And it said, hey, vicious attack, blah, 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 blah. The third line was,
stream his music.
Stream his music. Make sure his music is streamed 50 million times. Wait a minute now. You're not telling me that somebody involved in a hate crime is, you're trying to promote their music. That just don't seem right to me.
Feel like Taraji saying that.
I could never see Taraji saying that. And I don't know her, but it was
Felt
weird.
And if it didn't feel weird, it felt weird coupled with Lee Daniels' post and delete, and it felt a whole lot weirder when the video of whatever single she was promoting had a dude with a noose in it.
Mm. Mm.
I've seen enough.
Yeah. It's a little fishy.
I have seen a fucking enough.
That's some sick shit.
In my opinion, and this is my opinion, and I'm explaining this to y'all because I had to learn this as well. I had to learn why I couldn't immediately come tell y'all that I had a fight with seven niggas the day before the third story video shoot where I got my fucking ass beat. I couldn't tell y'all that.
Mm-hmm.
And I told some people that were in my best interest.
Mm-hmm.
And some of the conversation was, let's come up with a story. I'm telling you that when famous people are doing something that they have no business doing, sometimes stories are created to protect against that.
Absolutely.
And what better way to do it than something that no one will question, which is a hate crime.
Absolutely.
And if I thought you would question one hate crime, guess what the fuck I'm going to do? You guessed it. I'm going to put icing on the cake and make it two.
Mm-hmm. Mm.
You black nigger and you gay bastard.
Mm-hmm. Mm.
That is appealing to a multitude of audiences.
Yeah, for sure.
And what Jinx said to me earlier was, damn, I never even thought about none of this shit you saying, Joe, because I never looked past hate crime. You said it was a hate crime and I'm all in. That's the point, Jinx. Mm-hmm. We're in an era today where emotions are manipulated by the powers that be.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not saying that that is what's happening because I do believe that he was attacked. Did you guys hear the story that was on Reddit?
Mm-hmm.
You did?
Yeah,
you did? You did? Yes. Yeah. Should we share it with the audience? Should I do it? Should y'all do it?
Lovers quarrel. He was flirting with somebody else's boyfriend or lover.
And they followed him home from the gay nightclub in Chicago that he frequents often. And they beat him up. And not saying I believe that, but when I see the pictures of him beat up, that's how it looked.
Mm. And who's walking around because in cold Chicago with bleach at 3 in the morning?
Well, forget about that. I never met a kind racist that was attacking me.
Right.
If you're telling me that somebody who hated the fact he was black and gay attacked him, that don't match the picture I saw.
Mm-mm.
That's me. All I'm saying is there is at least 25 different reasons to be a little skeptical.
But lately something's changed, it ain't hard to define. Jesse's got himself a girl and I want to make her mine. And she's watching him with those eyes. And she's loving with that body, I just know it. And he's holding her in his arms late at night.
Source with intimate knowledge of the Jussie Smollett investigation tells CBS2 investigator Brad Edwards the attack on Smollett was potentially orchestrated by the actor himself and involved two other men.
Oops, there goes the neighborhood. Potentially fabricated. Well, it's probably somewhere in between. Probably exaggerated, probably intentionally spun. You know, something happened, but it ain't the something we've been told, and that's enough.
Chicago police calling those reports unconfirmed. We've also learned the persons of interest worked on the actor's show. Only CBS2 got a look at evidence obtained during a police raid. You can see investigators removed an Empire script, in fact. Our night team's Charlie DeMar broke the story at 6, and he's got even more exclusive details tonight.
Pause. Okay, so let's review. The two dudes in question that everyone was getting super boned up about, these are the two white guys. who are dark as a friggin' silhouette and who are stumbling around like they're black bums in Chicago. Turns out, they're not white, they're black. Now, Jesse is for sure positive that those are the guys, and they're black. That shall not be ignored. The entire thing was a lie.
Charlie. Rob, good evening, and we are being told that those two brothers who are currently in police custody left for Nigeria the same day of that alleged attack. They returned last night only to be detained at O'Hare Customs. Today we spoke exclusively with the attorney for those two men. She tells me that after talking with Chicago police detectives that her two clients, those two brothers, could be charged as soon as tomorrow. The front door busted off its frame, belongings thrown across the living room. Take a walk upstairs, bedroom doors damaged and clothes tossed everywhere. It's the family home of two brothers now in police custody being questioned in connection with the alleged staged attack on Empire actor Jussie Smollett, according to sources.
They were actually detained at customs at O'Hare Airport yesterday around 5:45 p.m. They had no idea what was going on. And they've been detained since then.
As the brothers were picked up by police at O'Hare returning from a trip to Nigeria, officers were at the home taking several items, leaving behind this inventory list of some of the items taken: a black face mask hat, an Empire script, a phone, receipts, a red hat, and bleach.
When they first learned about what happened to him, they were horrified. This is someone that they know, this is someone that they've worked with. So they don't want to see somebody go through that.
So they're denying it, but the evidence does seem to point in their direction. But of course, they're going to have a defense, and let's hear it. But you're telling me that the two people that the security cam footage found in the area at the same time of the alleged crime are two dudes that know Jussie, that worked on the show with Jussie, and then their home gets raided, and it come to find out that they have black ski masks and they have bleach. Does anybody think that's a coincidence? But these dudes are not just regular blacks, they're friggin' Africans, okay? They're Africans, so deal with this shit the same way that you deal with all black-on-black crime, which is to completely ignore it and keep your race-vulturing and fear-mongering about hate crimes to yourself, because we don't need it and we don't want it. And if you fake shit and you lie, we're gonna catch you and you shall be regulated upon. And you know what we need to do with said regulation? We need to act like Dikembe Mutombo, another African who would swat people who tried to dunk on him, who tried to shoot over him. He would reject them. Oh, they wanted to do something. Jussie wants to be a victim. Jussie wants to be more famous. He's almost famous. He wants to be an icon. But a little something called the truth, a little something called sanity, that needs to deny these people and their lies and stuff it right back down their face. In other words, get that weak shit out of here.
According to their attorney, Gloria Schmidt, the men have worked as extras on Empire and go to the gym with Smollett on occasion.
And see, what the hell is that? What kind of dude has that in his apartment? What? What is that? A guy with just the package and the freaking yoked up? What? They found that at their apartment? And that's what, a symbol of the gym or just a golden Adonis? I mean, this is gay. How is this not gay? No, it's because like that's the body I aspire to have so I could fuck chicks. No, wrong, gong. You want to fuck that statue. Along with the charade, that doesn't seem to be a reason to change. You know, I feel so dirty when they start talking cute. I want to tell her that I love her, but she's watching him with those eyes, and she's loving him with that body. I just know it, that he's holding her in his arms late at night.
We got some stories to tell here. We got Jenny from the Block. Do 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 do. Watch out. Do 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 do. Don't be fooled by the rocks that I like. Want to bring it up? Why do I bring it up? Well, because
I see similarities between Jenny from the block and Jesse from the block. Don't be fooled by the rocks that he got. He's still Jesse from the block. Maybe I'll call name the video that. Because, why do I say that? Who is Jennifer Lopez? She is a woman who grew to be famous because she has a fat ass. But because she portrayed a singer. She pretended to be a singer. Just like Jesse is pretending to be a singer on the show Empire. She pretended to be a singer on a movie about, what's her face? You know what I'm saying? This Selena. Selena. So, look at this.
To touch us all. With every triumph.
He is so cute. He's such a good friend.
And with every success.
She pretended to be Selena, and then she said, fuck it. Why don't I just be Selena? I mean, how hard is it to sing? We got auto-tune, we got, you know, whatever. We'll get people to write songs for us. And, you know, most of it's just wanting to fuck the person anyway. It's really not about singing at all. So she gets delusional, and she becomes this pop sing superstar. And she puts out songs like this, which is a dope beat. Listen to this. And it's undeniably a good beat, and it makes you want to move. Do 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 do, do 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 do. You know what I'm saying? A little do 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 do, and then it hits back to do 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 do. It just it resolves on a nice little do 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 do. Yeah, do 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 do. And here it is.
Children growing, women producing, men go working, some do steal. Everyone's got to make a living.
Hit me with the melody. Oh. Okay. But that hurt. You think you could rap on this? I could. Okay. Kind of reminded me of a little beat from a song I like to call The Beat Nuts, which came out multiple years before Jenny from the Block came out, and it's called Watch Out Now. And this is that song.
Watch out now.
Yeah, yeah.
Uh-oh. Similar. Uh-huh.
Don't be fooled by the rocks that I got. I'm still Jenny from the Block. Used to have a little, never have a lot.
And that was actually sampled from a song from 1975, which is this.
Hi-jay, your love. Hi-jay, your love.
There's two different groups of people. There's two brothers. The people in the picture, the people of interest, they've caught those guys. They're from Africa. And they knew the guy, and they had been extras on Empire and are gay. So you think that this is, and they're black. So this is clearly some domestic dispute that they have an issue with this dude. And something happened at the gay club. I like how that's not mentioned. I was out at a Subway at 2 a.m. No, you weren't. You were leaving a fucking gay club. And you were looking to get some grub.
Jesse is a friend.
Oh, no, 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 no.
Yeah, I know he's been a good friend of mine. No, 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 no. But lately something's changed that ain't hard to define. Jesse's got himself a girl and I want to make her mine. And she's watching him with those eyes. And she's loving him with that body, I just know it.
I like how he punches the body. And he's loving him with that body, I just know it.
That body, I just know it. And he's holding her in his arms late tonight. You know I wish that I had Jesse's girl. I wish that I had Jesse's girl.
Okay. I'm just saying get this fucking shit out of here, just like Mutombo.
Backed away by Mutombo. Oh. No.
Get out.
Blocked by Dikembe again.
And I want the top 10 Mutombo blocks of all time. all time Mutombo blocks. So get that shit out. Bring it? No, you get that shit out. Mutombo, he's waiting. Get it. Oh, God, he swang through it. That's the good old days. Nowadays, people just block it and try to retain possession. He's like, no. Possession goes to whoever's in the third row. Get that fucking weak shit out, Race Vulture. Number 9. I'll tell you if I like 9 or not. We got the Seattle Supersonics looking to go baseline on. Look at the fucking legs on Mutombo. Just spindly. He's got the knee braces. He's just an 8 foot tall. Where's he from? The Congo?
Seattle by one.
Oh, who's that? The Rain Man? Is that Sean Kemp? He's looking to go spin. He's spinning.
10 seconds on there the comes. Shot clock. John Kemp
No. Get it up. I don't reject it.
He knew DeCampi was there, and he wasn't even close on that shot. He handles him.
I like it. Just graceful.
He gives him a problem around the lane.
Number 8. Oh, Kobe's going to get dealt. Kobe. Get it up.
Rejected by Mutombo. DeCampi. Marv is an excellent help defender. He knows the defensive guidelines, and he is going to go to the front of that rim. Any kind of penetration.
Jim Jackson gives us the inches, but DeCampi Mutombo has his back.
We got more. We need more defense in this world. That's what we need. It's too much offense. We live in the social media scene is an offensive oriented system. So believe the accuser. Yeah, believe the potential victim. So go out there, make an accusation. We'll believe you. That's offense. You're on offense. You're trying to gain sympathy for yourself. We need defense. We need Mutombo. We need the Mutombos of the world to step up and say, you don't get the virtue points. You don't get the victim cred. You got to earn it. You got to take it strong to the hole. Get your weak shit out of here, Jesse. Jesse's girl.
Gets the booze. He has been the villain.
Oh, help defense? Get that shit out, good sir. Get it out. And all of you know that I was a blocking sensation. My hands are small because I think something to do with, like, you're only allowed a certain amount of flesh when you're crafted by God. And most of mine went to my cock. And so I had to take a few inches off the fingers. So I can't palm a basketball. I could palm a grapefruit. I could palm your girlfriend's tit. But I can't palm a basketball. But what I could do was leap. I had that leaping ability. And I have a little spring in my step. So I would just swat fools. And people, I'd win awards. Like, I'd go into basketball tournaments and I'd get the most blocks. Like, they'd just be like, damn, who's that white boy? White boy would be blocking fools. And just like this.
Comes over to swat it away.
Get it out.
Kendall Gill, Mutombo again, takes care of that one.
And the first standing ovation in the first 42 seconds of the game.
Love it. Number 5. Oh, God, he took that off the arc. Guy tried to float it over Mount Mutombo.
By Hill, Mutombo! No. There's a little finger wave to the crowd.
Oh, reward him. Here's the pass back. You see that? Look at Mutombo running the lane like a big-ass black gazelle.
Leading shot blocker in the
Give
NBA.
It up.
And the finish.
I think Mutombo just...
Grant Hill.
Just woke up.
Came up.
See, Grant was trying to float that, and he thought he gave him enough space. Look at that. Almost a goaltend.
Flipper.
Actually, that was a goaltend.
DeCampi Mutombo eats that for lunch, and DeCampi not settling for just the defensive play.
And he said that Mutombo eats basketballs for lunch, which is, I would say it's racist.
Two-point game for the
Memphis,
Rockets.
Drive the lane. He came at him. No. This ain't your highlight reel. This is my highlight reel, bitch. He said, where are you going, white boy? Get him again.
Blocked again by Mutombo, and the Rockets come up with it with 14 seconds left.
That's a good one.
DeCampi Mutombo has 4 blocks in the game.
Get out.
He got 2 on that play.
Number 3. Oh, God. Old Bulls action. A little pass here with that Scottie Pip. Is that MJ? Who's in the post? That's Dennis Rodman. He had been fronting on this guy. We had a mismatch. And Mutombo, the great equalizer. Look at the size of the feet. And that could be Jordan. Air Jordan. Because that's a shooting guard. What was his name? Harper? And that's Rodman. Wait, we have 1, 2, 3, 4. Where's the 5th bull? It's a bullshit. It's probably some white boy center who hasn't even made it down the court yet. Because Mutombo ain't guarding nobody, but he's about to guard Jordan.
There's a beat, Jordan.
Get your shit out, Jordan. Oh, see that? There's a white boy down here. It's like, I told you it was some slow-ass white boy. I don't even know who that is.
Blocked away by Mutombo.
Get that
Jordan
shit.
Jordan lost that ball going up. But out. Kimbe right there. Perfect time on that block.
Yeah, I mean, it's not even a fair thing. And Jordan dunks on him later in his career and waved his finger in his face.
Get a hold for the fresh shot. MJ. Oh,
he did it! Michael shakes the finger, but he finally got his dunk on Mount Matumbo.
He never dunked on you. He never put you on the highlight.
No.
No?
He said, I would love to have you in my poster, but it's not happening.
It's not going to happen.
You know he's lying.
And we, as a people, are not weak. So during that time before they came, it took them about
me.
And I'm not weak.
Okay.
As a gay man, you were considered.
Oh my God.
There's a level of pride there. We live in a society where.
Look at the tears in his eyes.
As a gay man, you were considered.
Unbelievable. All right. As a gay man, fucking ridiculous. As a gay man. Oh, it reminds me of Phil Hendry. Hold on. Phil Hendry, gay journalist, he used to joke about this all the time, as a gay man and a gay journalist, here it is.
I'm a gay man and a gay journalist, I don't need to check with my colleagues and look at their notes to make sure that I'm okay to file my story.
I'm not saying that, but what was the opinion?
I don't really know, I'm not really interested in what they have to say, I'm interested in what I've got to say, and I'm gay, you know that, right, Phil?
Yes, Doug, because for the last hour...
All right, I don't want to give you an opportunity, your audience an opportunity to go homophobe on me. What I'm saying to you is...
I'm not going homophobe. You've said that you're gay.
What I'm trying to tell you is, I write my own news story, and when this guy Brown walked up there and said, you know, I'm the winner, I'd like to officially announce that I won. I remember looking at a couple of guys, some meatheads, right, I shouldn't say this, but some meatheads from UPI. These guys didn't look like they knew what they were doing. I looked at them and I said, that is bull, and I used the expletive. And I walked out and I filed my story.
877-876-PHIL. All right, so that was the summation of your comment. 877-876-PHIL. Let's go to Steve. Steve, you're on the Phil Hendry Show with Doug Danger. Go ahead, sir.
Yeah, I'd like to really congratulate your guest there, because he's proven that a total blithering idiot can get on the radio and spew nothing but venom and have no opinion, no objectivity, and somehow he gets on the radio and you give him this floor. Wait a minute, I've got all... I'm a gay man and a gay jerk. So what? So that's all you've said the whole night. I'm a gay man and I'm a gay journalist.
Yes.
So what?
So what?
Anything else to offer?
It's called having the gay edge. I've got the gay edge.
It's called having the gay edge. As a gay man, what a fucking self-righteous shit. Nobody gives a fuck, Jesse, that you suck cock. Good Lord. Man, all of us straight guys would suck cock if we could reach. Unbelievable.
Somehow to be weak, and I'm not weak.
If you weren't weak, why would you be crying? Weak-ass bitch.
I am not weak. And we, as a people, are not weak.
We as a people? What, the gay people? Are you your own ethnostate of gays now? I don't see that lasting long. And that's because they cannot reproduce. Correct. They cannot reproduce. I'm sounding like Phil Hendry now. I'm having conversations with myself. What, we as a people? What, blacks? Jesse, you're barely black. Who's saying that blacks are weak as a people? Jesse, it's okay. It's not your fault. I feel like Robin Williams with Matt Damon. It's not your fault, okay? Jesus.
So during that time before they came, it took them about maybe half hour to come. And during that time...
Oh, I like how ABC sent the black in. Very sensitive. This is a very touchy subject. How many pins does Jesse have on? I see rainbows galore.
I was looking at myself, just like checking myself out. I saw the bruise on...
Look at him. That's a hospital selfie. He's like, look, is this my good side? I got a minor abrasion. Let me go to the hospital. They put him in a friggin'... What do they call that? The little shirt? Did they have to rip open your shirt with a scalpel? Please. How long do you stay at the hospital? Should I stay overnight, doctor? No, Jesse, you shouldn't. You have a minor nick on your cheek, bruh.
Bruh. Oh my goodness. So there is this story of this actor, Jussie Smollett, whatever his name is, and he's an actor on Empire. Never seen the show, can't tell you anything about it. And he's openly gay. So, of course, and he's black. Of course, so this dude was allegedly assaulted by two men, and it's turned out to be a hate crime because they said some slurs and stuff like that, yada, yada, yada. And it's just like the problem with this story, I'm not saying it's not possible, because let me recount what he wants us to believe. Let me recount. It's 2 a.m., right? He's leisurely stroll at freaking negative 5 billion degrees outside in Chicago right now, coming from Subway. All right, okay. Not going to ask why you were there in 2 in the morning, but whatever, that's you. Coming from Subway. These two guys in ski masks, because that's why you can't identify them. They had ski masks on. they say, hey, aren't you that blank from Empire? Blank. Jussie Smollett, he's like, yeah, that's me. They then allegedly get so triggered, so filled with hate, that they start beating this guy up. And they then pour a liquid on him. Some said it was bleach. We don't know yet. Pour liquid on him and put a noose around his neck. That's what he wants us to believe. That's what he did. And then after that, they just walk off. Now, here's the thing. Here's the thing. I'm like, wow, that's a crazy story. The two dudes just walking around. Oh, I forgot to mention. After they do all that, they then shout at him, 2 o'clock in the morning, this is MAGA country. I don't mean to make light of the situation, but that's a lot to take in. I'm sorry, in Chicago, there's a lot to take in.
On my neck, you know, like the little,
It almost broke the skin.
Burn around.
Jesse, this does feel a little weak. Like, courtesy of Jussie Smollett. What, he's getting a picture credit for this? Like he's an AP photographer? Fucking cares.
My neck. And then I smelled bleach. I know.
Oh, God. Here we go. Let's take a look at these pins. We have Black Power Fist. That's nice. Just racial tribalism. Cool. We win. Joke's on you, blacks. The black fades into his black smock. Whatever that is. Looks like something, I don't know, a gay dude from Star Trek would wear. And we have just a rainbow poncho. I don't know what that is. Just gay Mexican pride. And then a white thing, which is, who knows, give peace a chance. Who, love, a double gay. Does having 2 gay pins, does that cancel the... I'm dead.
All right. Bleach. I know the smell of bleach. And I saw on my sweatshirt, it had marks on it, like spots on it, when you have a bad bleach job.
Huh? So wait, who knows bleach? I don't know the smell of bleach. I mean, I had to dispose of the body of the homeless guy I killed in 1988, but like, that was so long ago that I've forgotten the scent of it. But who's talking about bleach? Is bleach a black thing? Are they bleaching their hair? Does it help their ashiness? Is it something to do with their elbows? I don't know what is going on with bleach.
So then I was like, there's bleach on me too.
Oh yeah, that must be a racist attack. I mean, fill in the blanks. Why would people pour bleach on you? Now, we know, Jesse, that the people that attacked you, quote-unquote, know you and are black. So that kind of puts a different spin, a different perspective on this whole fucking story. So why are black people pouring bleach on you?
So when the police came, I kept the clothes on.
What do you mean you kept the clothes on, as opposed to going naked?
I kept the rope.
So it's not a rope. There has to be a certain diameter of thickness before you call it a rope. There should be a certain diameter of thickness before you call it a dick, too. Hashtag TJ Kirk.
Had the rope on the entire time.
I mean, it wasn't like wrapped around, but yeah.
I mean, it wasn't even like a rope even. Like, I couldn't be hung from a tree by it.
It was around because I wanted them to see.
It's like some guy stabbed me with a spear. Did he? Well, you should file a report. Like, where's the wound? Are you bleeding out? Well, here it is. I was stabbed with this. That's a paperclip. Yeah, that's why I said a spear. No, that's a paperclip. What's the difference? It's a metallic thing that is pointy and it pierced me. So in my world, that's a spear.
I wanted them to see what this was. I told them what happened, everything. I also asked them to turn their body cams off because they were trying to stay in the hallway. And I was like, please just come in. Like, I don't want a big scene with my neighbors.
I don't want a big scene? Oh, Jesse, you're on live TV internationally with ABC News. And you're selling your freaking horrible music this whole time? You and your manager conspiring? Let's get some attention. Let's churn up some outrage. Oh, please, you don't want attention.
With like the second round of police officers, I went down to where it happened and I walked them through exactly what happened. And I looked up and I saw it.
And why is he not mentioning that he was at a gay club that night? He's acting like it's normal when it's negative 20 degrees in Chicago in winter to walk out to get a Subway. Like, I'm sure they have Uber Eats in Chicago. So you're just going to roll out in the middle of a polar vortex? No, you were out gaying it up. And now there are reports that you and your gay boyfriend got into a gay fight. At the gay club. The gay club. So can we mention that? Just say the word gay. For a start.
That there was a camera directly on the light post that is in the intersection.
And the camera didn't see jack shit happening.
So I'm like, there it is.
A potential break in the case that would eventually fall apart days later.
Uh-oh, Jesse was a friend. The camera didn't see shit.
And then the detective told me that the camera...
That camera's clearly a racist.
...camera inside of the casing was facing north, so they didn't have it.
Yeah, wouldn't you know it? Those damn genius homophobic racist attackers knew the direction of the frickin' local camera.
And...
They found a blind spot.
That was disappointing.
The vast...
Disappointed!
...majority of people have been supportive and loving and understanding.
Loving? Why are we loving on this man? Are we trying to love away the gay?
And then as time has gone on and that there's no... it's 2 o'clock in the morning. You're going to Subway. Sub-Zero.
Subway's open 24 hours.
No, Subway. So what if it's open 24 hours? What were you doing outside in a blizzard? What are you doing out there, Jesse? You don't want to mention you were at the gay club because now we're going to question everybody at the gay club. And we're going to be like, where was your boyfriend? What happened with you and him that night? What happened with you, him, and another dude? Was there a scuffle back then? Is that the motivation? Is that the reason those dudes followed you out? Is that why you got called out? Your whole story crumbles under the weight of reality. Respect my reality.
Like, people kill me when they say things like that because it's like Subway is open 24 hours.
So what? The hours of Subway is not the point, Jesse. If I show up at a Subway at 4:30 in the morning and then claim that I'm attacked in a hate crime and there's two black people, they attacked me. And it turns out there weren't two black people. And I got into a scuffle that I was partly responsible for causing with two white dudes. People are going to be upset with you.
It was for a reason.
You fucking race vulture. Oh, don't get sassy with me, good sir.
So that when you're hungry at night and you ain't got no food.
Oh, don't stop conjugating verbs just because you're black and sassy right now and angry. When you hungry. When you conjugate, you respect our language. Now stop disrespecting our language and get to conjugating, fool.
You go to Subway, the camera facing north. How is that my issue? It feels like...
What? Jesse, there's not any evidence of any of this. Stop bullshitting us, man.
If I had said it was a Muslim...
Oh, brings in the Muslims. If I had said it was a Muslim... Okay, no, now we are the problem. So we offer skepticism on this obvious bullshit story. Which it's already come out that it's bullshit. The whole thing is like just went through his fingers like a sand through your hand. right? And it's our fault now because we're on the right side of this. We were right to be skeptical. But, oh, let's, hypothetical, if it were a Muslim, let me guess, Jesse, because we're all Islamophobic, we would have been like, fuck those Muslims, man. I don't need any evidence. Fuck it. The Muslims did it. Nope, Jesse, you're wrong. So he's trying to double down and say, call us racist because this motherfucker just conjured up a fake hate crime and was a racist bitch towards white people saying, oh, these two white guys attacked me, when that's not even the case. It's a total lie. But he's going to say, y'all, not only are you homophobic and racist, which is not true, you're Islamophobic and xenophobic, you motherfuckers. That's the point he's about to make, which I've already debunked, but go ahead and make your point anyway. Jesse.
Or Mexican.
If Mexicans in Chicago going after people, oh my God. If it was a Mexican, huh? Porque no tiene, porque le falta dinero para gastar. Jesse, you're grasping now. You're reaching. Do you see the hate coming from this dude? Put another pin on there, Jesse.
Or someone black. I feel like...
It was someone black, you jackass.
The doubters would have supported me a lot much more.
A lot much more? That didn't seem like a coherent sentence. I feel like you could have done more, bigger, plus... added, increased to that.
A lot more. And that says a lot about the place that we are. In
it says nothing, Jesse. You just made that up. Jesse, you just invented that. It doesn't say jack shit about anything. Just like your made-up story doesn't say jack shit about Chicago or race relations or fucking Subway's operational hours. Doesn't mean anything, you jackhole.
In our country right now.
Many of those doubts around the issue of his phone, with some wondering why he didn't initially hand it over to
him. Because he's got straight-up dick pics on the phone, because he's gay as fuck.
Authorities.
They wanted me to give my phone to the tech for 3 to 4 hours. I'm sorry, but I'm not going to do that.
Jesse, why don't you do that? What the fuck is on your phone? Plus, what do you think the tech is going to do? Just... release it to live leak? You could stipulate that you don't want anything not related to the case to be exposed. They're not going to release your contact list, you dumb fuck. It's an investigation. They're the police. It's not TMZ you're releasing it to, you fucking... Oh, I was about to call them something that would have called... They would have called me a racist because there's a black. So everybody tiptoe through the wilderness. Through the what? Tiptoe through the... What is that song? Tiptoe through the tulips. Something like that. Fucking A, man. It's just bonkers to me. This guy is really tripling down on this bullshit.
Why?
Because I have...
Jesse, it's important. This has now become the biggest event of your life. Your name is now forever associated with this event. And you're not going to try to clear your name by corroborating your story? By giving them evidence? Some of the few, you know, bits of... technological, like a footprint that we could even ascertain anything that you're saying to be true. And by the way, if it's the whole thing that we're trying to determine is, did he call his agent? Yeah, I agree. He probably did call his agent to fabricate this story. But his agent has a conflict of interest and is clearly on his side no matter what. He's probably also a black power advocate, whatever.
I have private pictures and videos and numbers.
Who cares about the numbers you have? Are those the numbers you were collecting at your gay club?
My partner's number, my family's number.
So what, Jesse?
My castmate's number, my friend's numbers.
How about the numbers of the extras that work on the show you're on, which were the two black guys that were seen in the area that night? Do you have their number?
My private emails, my private songs, my private voice memos. I don't know what that's going to be to hand over my phone for...
Oh, so it's more about you. You don't really care about the truth. You're like, people should just believe me. Like, I've already said it. My truth is out there. Why do you need to see my dick pics? Why do you need to see my private songs? What the hell is a private song?
And honestly, by then, inaccurate, false statements had already been put out there.
Oh, that's rich, Jesse, coming from you. You're talking about inaccurate and false statements? That might come back to haunt you.
Earlier this week, he submitted phone records from within an hour of the incident, but Chicago police said they were limited and heavily redacted.
Yeah, they weren't anything. It was shit, Jussie. You didn't provide what was needed.
Adding they need additional information to corroborate the investigative timeline. His attorneys tell us they are willing to cooperate. Smollett also says he had...
Damn, she said corroborate and cooperate right next to each other. Very difficult to do. Nailed it.
...has been troubled by inaccurate claims.
What other ones had you heard that were inaccurate?
Her hair has grown in nicely since the cancer treatment. And that ain't no joke. She did have cancer.
That I had said that they were wearing MAGA hats. I never said that. I didn't need to.
Did you say they were white, Jussie? Are you going to say they were white again? Tell me they're white again. Say white again. Motherfucker. Oh, they wore black ski masks? But were they white, Jussie? Jussie? Kind of important, considering that's the whole story. Because nobody gives a single fuck that two blacks beat up a black in Chicago. That is such not... people. Blacks kill blacks in Chicago, and it ain't an international story. Let alone national. Motherfuck.
To add anything like that.
And that's some hideous-ass table art. What am I looking at? Look at that. What is that, a popcorn bowl?
They called me a...
They called me a fag. I get called a every day of my life, Jussie. And I'm straight as an arrow. A curved arrow. You hit? Jussie, you got to get a grip. Weren't you earlier saying you're not weak? I'm not weak. With tears in your eyes, you're talking about you're not weak. And you're like, they called me an agate. They called me it. They used the word.
They called me.
Oh, he punched that one out. Look at that. Don't look at her like all upset. They called me an N-word? I wonder if blacks call other blacks the N-word in Chicago, Jussie. Do you think that's going to happen tomorrow? The N-word will come out tomorrow on the south side of Chicago. Probably the north as well. I mean, Jussie, you're not a goddamn victim and nobody gives a shit that you got called an agate and an N-word. How about a nagget? We'll combine the two. Stop being a nagget, you fucking... You're nagging us with the story.
There's no which way you cut it. I don't need some MAGA hat as the cherry on top of some racist sundae.
Oh, it was racism. It was a racist attack. Jussie, were they white or were they black? It does matter. You said they were white earlier. So say it now, motherfucker. Now that the video footage is coming out or not coming out, or the fact that we have those dudes in custody, the two dudes that you said were the dudes. You saw a picture of them and you were like, yeah, those are the guys. Well, those guys were black, Jussie.
I've heard that it was a date gone bad.
Well, maybe not a date, Jussie, but a gay nightclub altercation. So you didn't go on a date with them, but you knew them socially. You know them professionally. I mean, is anybody going to mention that the two guys you're pointing out as being white perpetrators of hate crime are actually black guys that you knew from work? You don't think that's relevant?
Which I so resent that narrative. I'm not going to go out and get a tuna sandwich.
I resent the truth. A tuna sandwich? Oh, hold on. You got a tuna sandwich. Was it toasted or not toasted? And was there cheese on it, Jussie? Let's stay on topic here.
Which had a salad to meet somebody.
This is a red herring. This is a red tuna he's throwing out there.
That's ridiculous.
Wait, what?
And it's offensive. Yes, there's Grindr. Yes, there's Jacked. Yes, there's all of these things.
Grindr? How do we get to Grindr? I was just talking about tuna. If anything, that reminds me of heterosexual sex. Tuna fish. Now he jumps to Grindr? Jussie, you were at a gay club. Mention it. Just bring it up. Just let's talk about it.
Which I have not been on in years.
Oh, I haven't been on it ever. So let me one-up you there, Jussie.
I can admit that I was on that back in the day.
Oh, back in the day. Oh, back in the day. That reminds me of the song, Back in the Day, from Ahmad, who I went to high school with and played on the same football team with. Back in the day when I was young, I'm not a kid anymore. But some days I stop and wish I were a kid again. There you go.
Back in the days when I was young, I'm not a kid anymore. But some days I sit and wish I was a kid again. Back in the days when I was young, I'm not a kid anymore. But some days I sit and wish I was a kid again. Back in the days
when I was just a little nigga, I looked up to my bigger bro, begged if I could kick it. So,
and don't try to talk black. Don't try to up your blackness. You're fucking vanilla as a motherfucker, dude. My middle name is in Zulu. That makes me more black than you.
I was single. You know what I'm saying?
No, you weren't single for long. Not that night. Not the night you jump on Grindr. You be swiping right.
But I had.
Or is it left? I don't even jump on those shit. I don't swipe anyway.
I've been on that in years.
What were your injuries? What were they?
They did x-rays.
And found that they were negative.
I didn't have. It was reported that I had like fractured.
Look at that. He got a full-on cut. He got smacked. That's a slap. You got slapped in your face.
Ribs or cracked ribs or something like that. That wasn't true. I was just in a lot of pain. You know, my clavicle was messed up. My rib was bruised, but nothing was cracked. Like, I walked into the hospital. I walked out of the hospital.
Why do you think you were targeted?
Yeah, play the victim. Well, as a gay man and a gay journalist and a black.
I can just assume, I mean, I come really, really hard.
What? You come hard? Is this in relation to Grindr? What are you, dropping sick loads like Peter North? Let me cut to some B-roll of Peter North just dropping loads. He dropped a load. Let me try to recall grainy footage. Oh, God. It was shot in a square format, I recall it. Let me try to recall the woman's name. She was Eastern European in nature. All the names are kind of blended together. Black hair. I think maybe some of you know what I'm talking about. God, it makes me want to look it up right now. Oh, Olivia. No. I want to say it's like a Catherine Wilde or Black. No, Tory. Not Tory Black. Something Black, I'm feeling. Something Black and beautiful girl. Just tall, big tits, Eastern European. And Peter North just pulls out. He's standing up. She's sitting on a couch. And he just unfurls a fucking deluge of DNA, just baby batter. It's just bouncing off her lips, her face, her freaking eye socket, just coming in waves, man. Like, I mean, the tsunami in Japan or in Southeast Asia had nothing on what Peter North was dropping on this woman. I mean, he could have fucking just doused her face and had a little extra to put up her freaking uterus hole. I mean, it was that crazy. I don't know what that guy's drinking, what's creatine, protein powder. I don't know what he does to produce that level of just straight liquid. If I wanted to drop that, I couldn't pee that much on someone. And he just splattered the woman's face. Is that what you're talking about, Jesse? Is that coming hard? Oh, I come real hard. Yeah, I'm a gangster like that. You know, when I wear pins, I wear multitudes of pins. When I fuck up conjugations of verbs, I fuck them up real hard.
Against 45. I come really, really hard.
What? What about 45? Life. Grim fool that you're on the 45. Well, it's a grim fool that you're on the 45. Grim fool that you're on the 45. Well, it's a grim fool that you're on the 45. What are you talking about?
Against his administration.
Oh, 45 is a code for Trump? So these two ambiguously glay? These ambiguously glay black dudes. Hanging out in the middle of a fucking frozen tundra of Chicago, minus 20 wind chill, are really political activists who are against your Trump hate? Are you, what? How are we're supposed to believe that? Don't give me this shit. Don't try to drag Trump into this. Unbelievable.
And
look, oh God, do you see the pose on the black cancer girl? Look at her. She's looking at him like, the body language is crossed. Look at that. Closed for business.
and I don't hold my tongue.
Yeah. So strong. We got to silence that Jesse if we want Trump reelected.
Jesse Smollett.
I think that's horrible.
Trump looking bloated as fuck. Looking like they just dredged him out of the river.
It doesn't get worse, as far as I'm concerned.
Were you aware that he made...
Well, how about this, Trump? It gets a little bit worse when it's a total lie. When it's a complete fabrication. Meant to promote, self-promote, sell your stupid-ass music, and divide the races. Because black power...
Made that statement.
Uh-huh.
I saw it. I don't know what to say to that.
Yeah, man. Because I hate the dude, but he took my side on my fake bullshit.
You know?
Because he's the racist in chief, that 45.
You know, I appreciate him not brushing over it.
I'm all about that 187 on a 45.
And there is no doubt in your mind what motivated this attack.
I could only go off of their words.
Perhaps it was the subway employees. Here's a theory, hot take. I'm not sure if you've heard it. You didn't tip the dude for the tuna fish sandwich you bought. And he looked at you and he's like, hey, big fan of the show. I know you're a millionaire, motherfucker. Drop a tip in the bucket. You didn't. You stiffed him. They went out and slapped you upside your face. Case closed.
I mean, who says...
Uhuru?
Says Empire...
Agate Empire N-word. Who says that? I don't know. The voices in your head?
This MAGA country.
This MAGA country?
Ties a noose around your neck.
Ties it now, did they? They didn't just lasso you. They actually tied it around. This incident took 10 seconds. So when did this tying happen? It's not a noose. A, it's not a rope. It's most definitely not a noose. Jesus Christ.
And pours bleach on you.
Bleach. Get out of here with the bleach.
How's that for bleach?
And this is just a friendly fight? I will never be.
Friendly fight? Who called it a friendly fight?
The man that this did not happen to.
That's a weird way of phrasing something. I will never be the man this did not happen to. Jesse, I will never be the man that did believe this story that you're telling us right now.
I am forever changed. And I don't subscribe to the idea that everything happens for a reason, but I do subscribe to the idea that we have the right and the responsibility to make something meaningful out of the things that happen to us, good.
Out of the meaninglessness. So if you're going to subscribe to anything, subscribe to me, AIU. Atheism is unstoppable. What he is describing here is, it's a power play. It's a play to hype his career. The man is in business. This is not a private citizen. He's in the business of selling himself. And the way to sell yourself is to get noticed. For him to make it to the next tier of fame, he needs stories about him. He needs his name in your mouth. He needs his dick in the mouth of many men. Not that there's anything right with that. Not a single thing right about that. But that's what he's about. That's what he's doing right now. Okay? He wants the fame. He wants the fame to come in a positive light. As in, poor me. Look at me. I'm such... I saw an article they wrote. They're talking about him as a gay icon. A gay icon. How? Because he's on a TV show and he's gay? You're not an icon, bitch. I'm not a straight icon. If I called myself a straight icon, do you know what straight people would do? You know what the whole world would do? They look at me with a raised eyebrow and be like, bitch, you ain't not, you are not an icon.
Good and bad.
Again, this first time that he's giving said.
This dude right here is an icon. What's his name? Former linebacker for the New York Giants. Why can't I remember names anymore? Lawrence, that's not Lawrence Taylor. That's gap in his teeth. Michael Strahan. There it is. Michael Strahan. He earned his, he is an icon from the NFL. Great player. Earned everything he has. Nice personality. Although his fingers, look at that. That's problematic. That's a wide distance between your middle and your whatever that finger is called. Does anybody know the name of that digit?
Such a detailed account.
Is this a urine sample? What the fuck? If that is hot, I'm worried.
And he was really excited when he saw
the camera.
There's no way he could have known the camera was turned away.
Give me a break. Wait a minute. Look at this little fucking... This is like Ben Shapiro in 30 years. Who cares if the camera was turned away? There's no way he could have known that. There's a million other cameras. Okay, the camera... It's not that just that one camera. And... Wait, are you saying he didn't do this for the camera? Of course he did. What, he called the cops. He called his manager. He called all the outlets. He's doing all the interviews. He's turned this into a freaking bonanza, fiesta of coverage. The guy's not shying away from the... Are you kidding me? He's just an innocent guy. Just a private Joe Blow, just victim.
I didn't know, detectives didn't know until, and it was inside the casing, it was facing in the other direction, and he had no idea about that. And I asked him about if there were other possible threats that he had received, and he did talk about the letter that was sent to the Fox studio where...
Give me a fucking break, I get death threats.
Empire is sent. Police have confirmed that letter, and we'll show it to you in our next hour. And also, more importantly, there was many reasons why Jesse wanted to sit down and do this. First was to say thank you to his many supporters, to answer the questions, the critics, but also the times that he came emotional is when he was talking about gay youth and the LGBTQ community, the message for them and how they are viewing how this...
As a gay victim and gay journalist, as a gay actor, as a gay, oh, who cares, Jesse?
This is being handled.
But he was seeing pretty forthcoming.
He did not...
Forthcoming? How do you mean forthcoming? He's lying, Michael. Michael.
Nothing was out of bounds. There was nothing that I could not ask. And he truly wanted to... And he'll explain in the next hour the four main reasons why he wanted...
A lot of anger there, too.
Oh, yes. And as he said, he's not just angry.
Oh, we angry. We angry. And news shows like this, they should have stories like this just crammed up their ass. No homo. I mean, they need to suffer the consequences of their bullshit coverage of this. Their fucking complete lack of journalistic integrity. It's not even integrity, it's skill. You've heard one side of a story from a guy who has every motivation in the world to lie. Every. He has agendas, he has political ambitions. The guy hates Trump, for example. You don't think that's suspicious? I'll put it this way, do you think it'd be less suspicious if it was a pro-Democrat person? He's like, man, I got beaten up. And they were like, this is Bernie Sanders country, motherfucker. And I was like, damn, I voted for Bernie. What the hell? I'd be like, well, it's bizarre, but it's more credible than the fact that you're trying to say that your political opponents attacked you conveniently. Unbelievable.
Angry at what happened then, he's angry at what happened now. And he realizes, you know, he's on social media, he realizes that people, you know, some people are going to look at his interview right now and they're going to think one thing or another. He has no control over that, but he...
Oh, Jesse doesn't control the world? That's a shame.
Is adamant, and as I said earlier, the police have said he's been consistent, that he has been credible, that he...
No, what do you mean they've been credible? The police have most definitely not said he's been credible. Consistent? Okay, great. Ted Bundy was consistent in his lie. Scott Peterson, O.J. Simpson, they consistently lied. That's not credibility. Fucking hell.
He has been cooperative, and the investigation...
Cooperative? They just put out a statement saying he didn't release his phone records. They're like, this is limited, it's redacted, it is not helpful. The hell? I'm a better journalist than these people.
Is ongoing.
Yeah, they're still investigating.
It's just 2 weeks in.
God, this guy's so creepy. How about a little hair loss? Just a little? You're 65. Could you lose a little hair? It's outrageous.
Jussie Smollett from the hit show Empire was attacked and beaten early this morning in Chicago, and police say it could be a hate crime.
Yeah, we are in a post-racial society, right?
Apparently we... See.
It all started when two individuals yelled out racial and homophobic slurs.
We live in an accepting society that holds no contempt for the LGBTQ community, right?
They began to beat him up and then poured a chemical substance onto his body.
It's all in the past, remember?
I like the chemical substance, making it sound like it's an acid attack. If you pour soda on someone, that's a chemical substance.
investigating this as a possible hate crime.
Investigators say one of the offenders wrapped a rope around Smollett's neck.
And bringing it up only reopens old wounds. Those are some of the
yes, Francis.
Comments that I often receive when I do videos touching on racially sensitive or issues involving the LGBTQ community. But here we have an incident that happened in 2019. According to a Chicago police report, 36-year-old Empire star Jussie Smollett was assaulted Tuesday morning by two suspects who yelled out racial and homophobic slurs before the attack. The police report suggests the two men were wearing ski masks and viciously attacked Jussie as he fought back, but they beat him badly and fractured a rib. Furthermore, sickening details were added. These men allegedly put a rope around his neck and poured bleach on him. Jussie then took himself to the Northwestern Memorial where he was treated. He was discharged later Tuesday morning. Man. 2019, huh?
Did you see that smile? Right there?
19, huh?
Before he broke character and went down and put his head down in like this fake, upset sort of vibe. Man. Watch. He smiled.
Later
watch.
Tuesday morning.
Watch, watch, watch.
Man.
There. There's a moment. It's a micro expression. Look at that.
Later Tuesday morning.
There it is. His lips. His lips flex like that. That's a smile. That's a little smile. There it is. He's happy. It's another hate crime from the whites. I get to protect the blacks.
Man. 2019, huh? All right. Well,
yeah, man. People, I mean, God. Hey, humanity, change. It's current year. That argument hasn't worked any year. Every year it's ever been current year, that is a stupid argument.
Let me preface this with the fact that these reports are still currently being investigated by Chicago police.
Oh, and it's come to find out that they're all false. So where's the follow-up, Francis? Why are you... So if it's not about you reopening old wounds and inflaming, if, I mean, why is it too much to ask for you to do a correction video putting out the fire that you just started with this video? So you're fucking wrong. Now admit you're wrong and say, oh, instead of inflaming racial divide, I'm going to say, look, it wasn't about hate crime. It wasn't about whites versus blacks. This case, it's just some petty gay shit going on in Chicago that's probably going to be, you know, some unimportant mixture of some domestic incident between people that know each other. So it's not random. It's not strangers. And by the way, that is another aspect. It's not just the racial aspect, which is why anybody would care. It's the fact, once you say they know each other, now it's a totally different thing. This is not people jumping a random dude in the alley because blackness and because homophobia. No. This is dudes who know each other. Now motivations are going to be completely different.
In order to corroborate the claims. But let's start with what we do know. A man has filed a report in 2019 stating that he was attacked in sickening fashion for the crime of being a gay black man in the United States.
What the fuck are you talking about? The crime of being that? He didn't say that, and who cares if he did? I mean, again, the guy just trusts whatever the guy said? Amazing. So if I get attacked out there, I'll just go, oh, it's because I'm a British YouTuber. It's just hatred towards British YouTubers. Man, amazing. 2019, British YouTubers just being attacked for the crime of being a British YouTuber. Stunning.
An issue that has been on the rise, according to FBI statistics.
That's garbage. This is the whole point. This proves the point that the only thing that's increasing is the reported hate crimes. False or otherwise, and most of them are false. So this Jussie Smollett one, add that to the list. At literally another potential hate crime that is added to the list of hate crimes, and it turns out it wasn't a hate crime. So that's why you're getting these numbers. Not to mention, the FBI is now collecting, for the first year ever, hate crime stats from thousands of new organizations. So that's not mentioned in this headline, but that is the case. So if you read these stories, it says the FBI is taking hate crime stats from groups like the Southern Poverty Law Center, like the NAACP, any fucking group, thousands, not that's not exaggerated, thousands. And they add all those up and they go, we've had an uptick of hate crimes, according to the FBI. No, it's not according to anything. That is, again, just you're shifting. I mean, you're playing musical chairs with the truth. And it's just a perception is reality thing. It doesn't make sense.
17% from 2016 to 2017 and have continued to rise for the third consecutive year as we see heated racial rhetoric and actions come to the forefront in the news.
Bullshit. Now we see you, people like you, highlight and cherry pick the only, whatever you want. You could find whatever you, you know, you could find anything and just highlight it. And then you're going to blame, oh God, you see it in the media more. We see footage of black people being beaten up. So I guess that's probably happening more. No, it's not.
Furthermore, FBI stats have suggested that there is at least 2,459 confirmed anti-black hate crimes.
No, there's not confirmed at all. Learn what the word confirmed means. Those are confirmed reports of that. Wildly different. Again, these people are so incurious, they're so gullible, that they don't understand there's a difference between a claim and a fact. If the claim sounds like something they like, it's a fact. Run with it.
And 1,433 confirmed anti-LGBTQ hate crimes.
Yeah, right. Like, remember, what's his name? The guy that shot up the Pulse nightclub? That was an anti-LGBTQ hate crime, wasn't it? But it turns out it wasn't. So did that make the list? Anyone want to go verify that? Do you have anything to do today, this afternoon? Why don't you go find out if the Pulse nightclub shooting is officially an anti-gay hate crime when we now know for a fact it wasn't? And that he was just looking for any club in Orlando. He typed into Google club. And in fact, when he was there, he asked one of the security guards, where are all the women? He had no fucking clue it was a gay club, but he was out and about and he's like, all right, fuck it, it'll work. Allahu Akbar.
In 2017. And those are just the ones reported to police. Another issue that plagues the community that these attacks are often not reported out of fear of not being believed or shame.
Right, because they shouldn't be believed. Because they're not believable, because they never happened, because they are concoctions from their own minds. Minds of people who are not special, who want to be special, and their only claim to fame, their only sort of look at me moment is, I suck dick. That's their big freaking, ta-da, isn't it amazing? No, it's really not.
But according to Jussie Smollett's crime report, he was called both racial and homophobic.
Double whammy. It's like an intersectional, just cross-section of all the hateful bigotry coming together as one. Jesse, it's not good enough that he's black. He's also gay. Oh, my God. If only he was handicapped. Sorry, handicapable.
He carried both identities with pride.
What? How do you figure he carried them with pride? What are you talking about?
And his alleged attackers had hatred.
Hatred. The hatred for the gays. And I'm against the hatred. I love the gays.
Both of those communities.
Back in 2016, Smollett spoke openly about being gay in Hollywood. I do not hide who I am.
Who cares?
I love who I love.
And while they attacked him for those beliefs, this attack should be an attack on us all. Because this...
Why? What? An attack on us all?
This is far too often a common occurrence in the United States.
What? How do you figure it's far too often? According to what? What is too often? Hey, smartass, any attack is far too often, but we don't know the nature of this attack. It could be just a minor, petty, personal dispute coming out of a gay club. And got news for you, there are fights in clubs, straight or otherwise, every night. Go ask the bouncers. An attack at a club is an attack on all of us. Really? Really? It wasn't just a drunk guy who stepped on the foot of another drunk guy or looked at his girlfriend in a lustful manner? Or just a guy looking for a fight with a Napoleon complex? No, it's an attack on us all because we must fight against the homophobia. Right. Retarded.
We live in a society that people find ways to deflect or diminish someone's claims that they were racially abused.
Deflect or diminish? No, how about expose and out the fact that the claims were horseshit? Complete fabrication. How about expose and out the fact that you covered the story and ran wild with it because you want to promote yourself? As evidenced by the fact that your stupid-ass Twitter and Instagram haven't left the screen. Haven't left the screen. Francis, it's worse than a watermark. Watermarks have the tendency to be minimal. Half transparent. Dude, I've seen dudes like M. Night Shyamalan don't have egos like this. And he puts himself in every movie and he can't act.
And he'll start a movie saying, written by M. Night Shyamalan, directed by M. Night Shyamalan, starring M. Night Shyamalan, produced by M. Night Shyamalan. He'll do it one after another. He won't say, he will not say written, directed, and starring M. Night Shyamalan. No, he'll give you a separate screen. So directed by, pause, M. Night Shyamalan. New beat, M. Night Shyamalan. Even that guy brings his name away from the screen and lets you watch an hour and a half of his fucking terrible film. You keep it up the whole time. What does that say, Francis? It says that you're the show. That's the motivation for this. You. The same way that Jussie has fabricated the story, you are leveraging this story, and you don't give a fuck about gays or America or actual crime or any actual problem that we have. What you care about is that gay as shit jacket you're wearing. Fucking leather, brown leather. Burn it. Burn that in some sort of satanic ritual. I'll burn it. I'm not even going to talk about your turtleneck or your fucking ginger beard as if that should be legal. Fucking hell, Francis. I'm flustered.
Or they were abused for their beliefs, then actually address...
Actually? God, did he wrestle with that in his mouth. You might have to have a defibrillator. Take two. You might have to have a defibrillator. That's not even the word. Not even defibrillator. Okay, you try it at home. You think it's so easy? You try it. I'm not even going to say it. You go. Say it now. I get the defib. It's the next part that's tough. Defibrillator. Defibrillator, to fib or not to fib? That is the question. It's fun to talk. Talking's fun. See, this is my problem. It's not defib. It's defib. It's defibrillator. I need to pronounce that. I don't want to learn how to use it. I want to pronounce it. Okay, forget using it. I don't even know how to say it.
Defibrillator.
Oh, do I have to say it like I'm Stephen Hawking? Defibrillator. Defibrillator. Defrib. I was going with defrib. What's wrong with defrib? Just swap out the R. Defibrillator. Don't make me wait for
defibrillator.
It. Huh?
Defibrillator.
Now, what about fibrillation just in general? I mean, because I want to defibrillate, but...
Defibrillator.
What?
Defibrillator.
Okay. Let me try it again. Defibrillator.
Defibrillator.
Am I getting it? Defibrillator.
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 I'm bettering myself. I'm evolving. I'm evolving as a human being. Incredible. Wow. Okay, hold on. Be honest. Who among you can say that? I'm going to see if the honesty reigns supreme here. Because I'm calling bullshit. You butchered it. Admit it. My problem was I wanted defrib. My heart was telling me defrib. Get on chat and I'll prove it. It's not the easiest. No, it's very difficult. I got it, but I'm not confident. You're right. I need practice. Squirrel is impossible. Fucking hell, man. It was a good joke too. I was trying to make fun of a man for not being able to speak, and then I just ran into defibrillator. Defibril. Who says that's easy? Impossible. Defibril. So unnatural, man.